You guys showed great support on this thumbnail design video. However, many people complained about the speed of the tutorial. So here's a more detailed video on how to create these glowing style thumbnails in Photoshop. Plus, I'll share free resources to speed up this process even more. Be sure to watch the full video to understand how to use them. Otherwise, you'll get errors and it won't work properly. Now open Photoshop and let's get started. We'll start by creating a new file. 1920 width and 1080 height. Leave other settings and click on Create. Click on this icon and then Solid Color. Choose black color and click OK. Then create one more solid color and this time choose a vibrant yellow. Click on this mask and press Ctrl I to invert it. Then take the brush tool from here. While holding Alt and right click, if you drag the mouse left or right, it'll make the brush bigger or smaller. Similarly, if you drag it up or down, it will make the brush softer or harder. Make it softer with a bigger size and make sure the flow is set to 100 and then just click once. Take Direct Selection tool and adjust the size and position. Then click on the solid color layer and press Ctrl J to duplicate, double click on it and change the color to sky blue. Adjust its position as well. These will be the light sources of our subject's highlights. We'll use this in our thumbnail. To remove the background, take any selection tool from here and then click on Select Subject. Now, with selection active, click on this mask button. Now drag it into our main document. Place this layer on top and adjust its size and position. Then select the solid color layers and reposition them. Once done, create a new white solid color below the subject layer and invert the mask. Then take the brush tool and decrease the flow. Make the brush softer with a bigger size. And paint on these areas. It is just for a more brighter glow. When it's done, select all the background layers and press Ctrl G to group them and rename it to background. It's just to keep things clean. And then we can unlock and remove this background layer. To make highlights, click on this button to create a new layer. Set black as foreground color and press Alt Backspace to fill the color in the selected layer. And change its blending mode to screen. Now click on this button and make a gradient map layer. Click on the gradient in Properties panel to edit. While holding Alt key, drag this slider to duplicate it and place it around here. Then take one more and place it here. Black and white sliders should be on the sides and these two in the middle. Now double click on this slider and choose your main color. Then double click on the other one and this time choose a darker shade of your main color. And then hit OK. Now hold the Alt key and left click between these two layers to make a clipping mask. Select Black Fill and Gradient Map layer and press Ctrl G to group. Now while holding Ctrl key, click on this mask to make a selection. Select the group and click on this button to create a mask. Now you can take the brush and paint with white on the black fill layer. And the paint won't spill outside of the subject layer. Setting up these layers is too much work, right? I've made an action that you can use to make these layers easily. First, let's delete these layers. Here's the action named Highlights Layer Setup. You'll find the link in description. Just double click on it and it will load inside Photoshop. Open this folder and there's the action. Now to use it, first you have to do a few simple things. Make sure the background of your subject is removed, then right click on the layer and convert to Smart Object, and then double click on the name and rename it to Subject with a capital S. With Subject Layer selected, open Actions panel, select our action, and then click on this Play button. And there it is! All the layers created in a second. You can click on the gradient in the properties here and change the colors, but I'll leave it for now. And let's paint the highlights first. Select this layer which literally says paint here. Now take the brush and increase the hardness and make it smaller. Set the flow to around 14%, make sure the foreground color is white, and then start painting on this side. Paint like this and no need to be perfect. And by the way, I'm using mouse for this and there's no need for tablet. Once you're done painting, make the brush softer and increase the size. Press X to switch the colors. Now with black as foreground color. Paint like this to erase. Make the edges softer. Using the same method, continue painting on the other areas. Make the brush smaller or bigger where needed. I'm speeding it up here because it's just the same process. You get the idea. For painting, use white color, and to erase, paint with black color. And once it's done, it's time to change the colors. You can change it manually, but I'll use the pre-made gradients. You'll find the link for this also in the description. Just double-click on this and the gradients will be loaded in Photoshop. Once again, click on the gradient to edit colors. Now scroll down to our imported gradients folder. Open the folders and here are the gradients. You can choose any of these without having to manually edit. I'll choose this yellow one and then hit OK. Now for the other side, select the subject layer again and go to our action and play. See how easy it is. We've got a separate group for the other color. We'll rename it and then I'll change this one's color to cyan or blue. Then select this layer and paint. It's exactly the same thing as the other side, so I'll skip to the next part. Both sides are done. Now to make those glowing thin lines or strokes, we'll select the subject layer and use our action once more. But this time, right-click on it and click on Ungroup and place both the layers on top. We'll choose yellow gradient for this one as well. Then select the paint layer, set the flow to 100, brush should be smaller, and with white as foreground color, draw the line like this. You can draw straight lines with brush by holding Shift key and then just creating points. This is exactly what I'm doing there, creating very small straight lines. So, let's get back to it. Draw the line on this area, and when it's done, press X to switch colors, and with a softer brush and with bigger size paint with black like this to make the edges pointy or smoother. I'm doing it quickly, but you can take as much time as you need for the best results. And then do the same for the hair. Draw the lines with small hard round brush and then erase with softer brush. We can also decrease the flow and then paint like this on hair to give some more detail to it. You can also use smudge tool for this, but I'll stick to just the brush tool for this video. Similarly, we'll paint on the ear as well. And then we will use the same technique to paint some highlights on the left side, this time with a sky bluish gradient colors. Our highlights are done. Now, let's do the remaining stuff. What I'll do now is select the subject, highlights and this white solid, and make them slightly bigger, and just rotate a bit. Then create a new solid color layer on top of everything. Choose yellow color and change its blending mode to linear dodge. Click on the mask and press Ctrl+I to invert it. With white as foreground color and lower brush flow, paint like this using softer brush. This will be the sort of glow that reflects off the surface. Just some small details. When it's done, create one more solid color but with a different color for the other side and simply paint exactly as before. Looks good so far. Now it's time to add an image or graphic on the left side of our design, but make sure it's relevant. In this case, I'll use this screenshot of this channel's videos. Right-click and convert to Smart Object and drag it to our main document. Place it right above the black background fill. Zoom out a bit. And click on any of these transform points. Then right-click and choose Perspective. Then drag this corner up. Play with all these points and look for a good angle. Make it look like 3D. Right-click again and click on Scale to adjust the size. Experiment with these and see what looks best. Once this is done, select this screenshot layer and click on this button to make a mask. Take brush tool with black color and paint on this area to remove it. Make sure the flow is set to 100%. Now take the type tool from here and click anywhere on the canvas. I'll write just the first word and click on this button. Change its color, but it doesn't matter because it'll be changed later. I'll choose Burbank Big Condensed Font for this. And scroll down to type options and click on this all caps button. Now press V for direct selection tool and scale it up a bit. After that, hold Alt key and drag the text below to make a copy. Double click to edit the text and then scale it down. Now select tutorial text and click on this button and then gradient overlay. Now click on this gradient and double click on the slider to change color. We'll choose yellow for this side, hit OK, and then orange for the other side. Click on OK once done. Leave the angle at 90 degrees, check on this reverse box, it'll flip the gradient colors. Decrease the scale and you can reposition the gradient directly by dragging like this. And then hit OK. Adjust their sizes. Then we can add one more effect on the text. Click on this button again and this time choose Bevel and Emboss. Set the style to Inner Bevel and then these are my settings you can copy if you want. See, it added subtle highlights on text. Now select both text layers and right-click, then convert to Smart Object. Then, once again, we'll click on one of these transform points and then right-click and choose Perspective. Try to match its angle to our screenshot image. Once it looks good, click on this button and then drop shadow, opacity at 100, size is OK at 18, and then I'll just drag the shadow around here and hit OK. Now make a new black solid color, drag it below the text, click on the mask and invert it. Take the lasso tool from here and make a rough selection like this. With white as foreground color, press Alt Backspace to fill in that area. Increase a lot of feather in the mask properties and then decrease the opacity as much as you like. Then select both the layers and place below our subject and highlights. Then we can select the mask and take the brush and paint with black color to remove some shadows from this area. Imported this arrow icon and scale it down. Place it around this area. To add the same gradient and effects like the text onto this arrow, double-click on this icon on the text layer. To get inside, it's just like a folder. It has our text with all the effects. By the way, you can change anything here and press Ctrl S and it'll be updated in our main document. But we don't need it, so just press Ctrl Z to undo, get back to the smart object. Now, right-click on this layer and click on Copy Layer Style. Here, select Arrow Layer and right-click, then paste Layer Style. Also hold Alt key and drag this drop shadow to the arrow layer. Then imported this 3D YouTube icon. You can use any icon or element related to your video. We'll place it here. And then go to Filters, Blur, and then Motion Blur. We'll keep the angle straight and increase the blur. And click on OK. Now with this Photoshop icon, we'll right-click and choose Perspective to change its angle like we did before. Then, place it here in the corner. Now drag this motion blur from YouTube icon and drop it on this layer. Click on this arrow to see the filter and then double-click on it to change the settings. We'll change the angle for this and decrease some blur. Then click on OK. Then duplicate these icons and place on different positions. Also change the angle and size using perspective and scale. Just make everything look good. After that, I imported this bokeh or particles overlay and placed it below the subject layer. Transform and position it where you want. Then go to Filters, Blur, and then Gaussian Blur. Add just a subtle amount. This is an optional step. With layer selected, press Ctrl U for Hue Saturation Adjustment Layer. Check on the Colorize box, increase the saturation, and use the Hue slider to change the color. Click OK. While holding Alt key, click on this button to create an inverted mask. Change the layer's blending mode to screen. Take the brush with white as foreground color and paint on the areas where you want those particles. Hold Alt and drag this layer below to make a copy for the other side. Remove this hue saturation adjustment because it is already yellow, so no need to change color. Click on the mask and with black as foreground color, press Alt Backspace to clean up the mask. Now take the brush and paint with white color on this area. Lastly, I did some small edits, like changing the angles, sizes, opacity, and readjusting the colors and masks. Nothing too complicated. When everything looks good, press Ctrl, Alt, Shift, E to make a stamp visible layer. It merges everything into a single new layer. Right-click on it and convert to Smart Object. Finally, go to Filters and Camera Raw Filter. Open the Effects tab first and increase the texture and clarity. Not too much, just where it looks good. Then, collapse the color tab and increase the vibrance. Lastly, go to the light tab and decrease the whites and increase the blacks. And then click on OK. That's it. This is how you make glowing style thumbnail designs. They may not be very realistic, but they're highly clickable. What do you think of this type of thumbnails? Let me know in the comments. And what next should we create?